Now, meanwhile, I'm listening to Dylan and Morrison and John Armitrading and Johnny Mitchell, and all my 15 and 16 year old buddies have discovered that there's this thing called punk music. And I'd like to be cool and say, oh yeah, I was into Sex Pistols in 1976. I didn't like them at all, actually. I didn't like the aggression. It scared me a bit, and I didn't get it, okay? I confess, all right, I wasn't into punk in 1976 or 1977. But then it kind of morphed a bit, right? Yeah. And then you're getting Elvis Costello, Blondie, Squeeze. I'm definitely going to play a Squeeze track. Graham Parker, who's kind of new wave, yeah, kind of singer-songwriter, rocker.
The Clash.
The Clash, as they became less, you know. But nobody could deny London Calling. And then we just... What?
Strangers,
of course, No More Heroes. I think the first two songs that I really got was Public Image by Public Image Limited and No More Heroes. Also a Clash song, but not one of their best known songs. I can't remember, off the second album. Anyway. Then we discovered, oh jeepers, there's Irish bands doing this. And look, I don't care what anybody thinks about U2. When U2 came along in 1978, and Fanning was playing Out of Control and Boy Girl and Stories for Boy, it was serious. It was really exciting. You listen back to the stuff and you think, it's not really great, is it? Well, anybody that was around kind of felt something. This band, it only happens once a generation, probably. You got the Beatles. I know the Beatles were magnificent and all that, but there's something extra. The X Factor, whatever that is. And U2 had it, and we all went to see them in the Crescent in... 1980, February 1980. I never became a big U2 fan, but there was something, you know? Just remembering, you know, the present. So would you know listening to that was going to become the biggest band in the world? I don't know.
No.
It's weird, isn't it?
The Blades were ahead of the
test. The Blades, I don't know if the Blades were quite there at that stage. They're not on this. No, this is just for kicks. This is a compilation of Dublin bands in 1979. Yeah. The Blades would have been on it if they were around, unless they couldn't for copyright or licensing reasons be on it. But I think they'd be more 80, 81 than...
Yeah, they started recording in 1980.
Yeah.
Did it?
Okay. I'm going to just throw on a couple of seconds of... it's pretty John Dundon isn't here, actually. John has been at the last few, he's away, I think, and he ran a venue called The Gaff. And he brought a lot of punk bands and new wave bands. Again, I wasn't a huge fan of that stuff, but there was a couple of the bands. Big Self was one, and then this crowd. Johnny Finger's sister is one of the people in this band, the New Versions. Just got to play a couple of, just a minute of it. It's called Tango of Nerves. Okay, you mentioned the Stranglers, and I was saying the song, the Public Image, which I think is a great song, and this one. Alcohol, but don't feel good as well around that time. say, I didn't really get punk for a while, and even when the Undertones came along, again, another confession, I didn't really like the Undertones. I didn't hear Teenage Kicks. First song I heard about them was Jimmy on Top of the Pops. And I thought, geez, this guy is like an altar boy, and the song is very basic, and Jimmy, Jimmy, oh. I thought, stupid. Then they came to Limerick, and I wasn't going to go, but one of the guys in my class got one tickets in a radio thing, right? And he realized that it was a two-part ticket, but they were only selling one part. So he was supposed to have two tickets, but he actually had four. I don't know if you get what I mean.
Yeah.
Anyway, Kevin, I bought a ticket off him. I said, I'll go, the lads are all going. And talk about Road to Damascus, you know, the gig. Anybody here at that gig in Savoy, February 1980? Of course, Nicky was there. Now obviously Teenage Kicks is the obvious song, so I won't play that. I'm trying to find track six on this. One, two, three, four, five. I think this is it. Yeah. Just. Oh, that's the end of it. Oops. There's a lot of tracks in it. Again, it was about energy, wasn't it? You know, I didn't get it when I saw it on Top of the Pops, but the Savoy. Oh man, it was incredible, you know. And there was a huge amount of trouble at that gig, but it all happened over at one side. We had a great time, we didn't know any of that was going on. The film Good Vibrations, if you haven't seen it, it's fantastic. And again, I don't know if that's one that we have here. I don't think it is, actually. Good Vibrations is about that record label, Terry Hooley, set up in Belfast to record these guys. I think it was Rudy was the band. But then the Undertones signed up with him as well. And it's a great film. He was a completely maverick character. I definitely should see that. Oh yeah, and there's a whole moment in it where they release, the Undertones release Teenage Kicks and they're not getting anywhere with it, and John Peel picks it up, and he plays it, and then he plays it again, and it's like, oh, he said, that's so good, I'm going to listen to that again, and he played it twice in a row on the radio, and like, you know, it was just amazing.